Hello student, today we are going to discuss long short-term memory LSTM. So before discussing what is LSTM, first we will discuss what is the limitation of recurrent neural network. In the last videos, we have discussed how to design a recurrent neural network for sequence classification and sequence labeling. We have also discussed how to calculate the loss function with respect to U, V and W. So if we are interested to find the loss function at this layer with respect to W's, we have derived this equations for calculating the loss function at layer 4 with respect to W. At layer T, the loss function is given by this equation. We have also seen that the loss function at layer 5 is dependent on the loss function loss at layer 4, loss at layer 3, layer 2 and layer 1. That means the loss function at this layer is dependent on the loss function of all previous layers. We have also discussed in detail in the last video. So now today we are going to discuss what is exploding gradient and vanishing gradient. So as we have seen that this is equations that we are using to calculate the loss function at layer T with respect to W. So now we can see in this equations that the loss functions is multiplied by the previous layer loss function with respect to W. So the loss function at this layer is multiplied by the loss function at the previous layer. So we can see in this equations also. So we need to notice one thing here, that if we increase the multiple terms. So if the value of these terms is very high, like the value of this term is 100, the value of this term is 200, the value of this term is 244, the value of this term is 249. So if we multiply these all terms, then the value of these terms is very high. So this situation is known as the exploding gradient. I'm repeating again, if the value of these multiplications is very high, it is known as the exploding gradient. Similarly, if the value of these terms is very high, like the value of this term is 0.2, 0.0.1, 0.0.2, 0.0.4, and once we multiply these all terms, the value of this terms is very less. So this is known as the gradient vanishing problem. Okay, so as we have seen in the real time scenario, we have a long input. So like if you are interested to find the activity in the video, so if the video is 30 minutes or 1 hours, it will having a number of frames. So if your frame is 10,000, that means these steps will be more than 10,000. Okay, so once we multiply these steps, you will your recurrent neural network will be suffer by the exploding or vanishing problem, vanishing gradients. Okay, so vanishing and exploding gradient we have discussed. Now let's discuss what is the limitation of recurrent neural network. So as we have seen, if the size of the network is high, okay, or in other words, if we having a multiple number of layers, then your recurrent neural network will be suffer by the exploding and the vanishing the gradients. The second problem in the recurrent neural network is that your input is morphed by the multiple times. So suppose that this is your 5 layer model. So this input is morphed by this layer. So for assume that if you are having the 1000 layers, then this input will be morphed by the 999 times. So it means this input is completely changed when it reaches to the destination. So this is another problem of recurrent neural network. And the last problem, because your network is too long, so during the gradient during the back propagation algorithm, this input will not be modified efficiently, because the reason is your chain is too long. So these are the problem of recurrent neural network. Now we discuss how to deal with this problem. So suppose that if you have a whiteboard and with the constraint that you cannot write arrays once you write on the whiteboard. So since initially your whiteboard is empty, so when you writing on this whiteboard, the information is easily readable by anyone. But with the time your whiteboard is too messy, and it is not in readable form. And in other words, we cannot extract the useful information from this code. So same situation is in recurrent neural network, because your input is morphed again and again and again and again by the multiple layers. So sometimes it is very difficult to extract the useful information from the input, because your input is completely morphed at the last layers. So to deal with this problem, suppose that you have a whiteboard of 2x2. So because your whiteboard is small, so assume that you can write only 5 steps at a time, and you are interested to calculate the value of this equation. So after writing these 2 equations, now you can write only 3 equations on the board. So these are the various steps that we need to perform in order to compute the value of these equations. So first we are calculate the value of AC, then we calculate the value of BD, then we calculate the value of VD plus A. So this is known as a selective read, because we are reading to calculate the value of AC, we are reading only value of A and C, value of B and D, and then value of BD and A. So this is known as a selective read operation. That means we are reading the selected information from the given input. Selective write operation means you are writing this useful information only. So suppose that in the case of AC, we wrote AC equals to 5. Okay, if we write AC equals to 1 cross 5 equals to 5. Instead of writing BD equals to 33, we will write BD equals to 3 multiplied by 11 equals to 33. So we are not writing the intermediate information. So we are writing the only useful information. This is known as a selective write operation. Okay. So, and then the selective forget operation, because we can write only at 3 sentences on the board at a time. So in order to write the calculate the value of AD, so we need to erase at least 1 sentence. So what we did, that because we have seen that there is no need of BD, so we erase this, the value of BD, and then calculate the value of AD, and then calculate this value. So to remove this statement from the board is known as the selective forget operation. So we have seen selective read operation. In the selective read operation, we are reading the useful information from the board. Selective write operation, we are writing the only useful information to the board, and forget information, we are erasing or removing the unuseful information from the board. Okay. So same mechanism is applied to the RNN network in order to design the RNN efficient RNN network. So suppose that if you are interested to design a recurrent neural network for this for the sentiment analysis of this review. Since this review is too long, so what we are doing, that we are applying the selective read, write, and forget operations to design the recurrent neural network for this sentiment analysis. So first we will remove the stop word, because as we know that the stop word does not contain any useful information like A and the, you know, so these all are the stop word, and then first we will remove. So this is known as the forget operations. Then we will read the useful information only, selective read operation. That means, so in the case of sentiment analysis, we are mainly interested to find the positive or negative words like good, bad, amazing, awesome, you know? And we are talking about the movie. So these are the some useful words. So in the selective read, we are read the selective word only. Or in the write operation, we are passing the selective informations to the next. Next stage. So this is known as selective write operations. Yeah. So LSTM is a special type of RNN network which is capable of learning long-term dependency with the help of selective read, write, and forget operations. So in the RNN, we have seen that we are passing the previous informations multiplied by the weight, input information multiplied by the U to and the bias, and directly passing to the next stage. In LSTM, instead of passing the direct informations to the next state, we are applying the selective read, write, and forget operations, and then we will calculate the value of ST. So this is your normal recurrent neural network. this is a equation that we are using for calculate the value st, where the input is multiplied by the weight matrix u, then the previous state is multiplied by the weight matrix w and b, and passing the summations to the sigmoid activation functions in the case of recurrent neural network. Now, so first we are going to apply the selective write operation. Selective write operation. So selective write operations means we are selecting the only useful informations. We are only write the useful informations from the previous stage. So this is achieved with the help of output gate O T minus one. O is instant for the output gate. T minus one is the steps. Okay. So this, the output of this stage of the previous stage is passing to the output gate in order to achieve the hidden state. Okay. The value of output gate is between 0 to 1. 0 means that we are not interested to pass this value to the next stage. 1 means we are interested to pass the complete value to the next stage. If the value of output gate is 0.9, that means we are interested to pass only 90% of this information. We are only interested to pass the 34% of this information. We are only interested to pass 20% of this information to the next layers. So this is known as the selective write operation. Why it is known as the selective write operation? That we are, because we are writing this only selective informations to the next layer. And why it is called the output gate? Because it's passed the only useful information. That's why it is known as the output gate. Okay. So what we are doing, that simply we are, this symbol indicate your point-wise multiplication. So we are multiplying 1.4 to 0.2, 0.4 to 0.34, and so on. So this is now we are getting the value of st minus one. But the question is how to calculate this value ot minus one, because how much information of this layer is passing to the next layer is dependent on this value. Okay, so as you all know that we have already discussed the sigmoid activation function and tanh activation function. These are the two activation functions that are used in the read, write, and forget operations. Okay, so in order to perform the selective read, write, and forget operations, we are using the three gate: input gate, output gate, and forgot gate. And these all gates are mainly used two type of activation function. One is sigmoid activation function, and second one is tanh activation function. The reason is the output of sigmoid activation function is 0 to 1, and the output of tanh activation function is minus 1 to 1. So if we are interested to find the value of this, we will pass this information to the sigmoid activation function. So the output will be between 0 to 1. Okay, so this is a way by which we will calculate the value. Now this is a equation which is used to calculate the value of OT minus 1. Now that means these are your parameters UT0, WO, and BO. So these are the parameters of input weight parameters, or your weight parameters, and YS for the output parameters. These are the parameters that we learn similar to the U, V, and W and B in the recurrent neural network. Okay, so these are the parameters. So just we will point-wise multiply this ST minus 1 to and OT minus, then we will get the output OT. Sorry, output HT minus 1. Okay, here OT minus 1 is the output gate. So the output gate decide what the next hidden state should be. Okay. The output gate is a hidden state. The new cell state and the new hidden state is then carried over to the next time step. Now these are the some symbol that we are going to use in our next slide. Red instant for the sigmoid activation function, blue is for the tanh activation functions, indicate the pointwise multiplications, addition indicate the pointwise addition, and this is for your vector concatenation. So now in the case of output gate, first we pass the previous hidden state. So this is your previous hidden state, and the current input, this is your current input, because we are talking about OT minus 1, so X minus 1 your current input, and ST minus 2 your previous hidden state. into a sigmoid activation function. Then we pass the newly modified cell state to the 10H activation function. Then we multiply the 10H output and sigmoid output to decide the information. Then we multiply by 10H and sigmoid outputs. Okay, so we can see in this figure also. Here we can see this is your hidden layer output. This is your input. Both are passed to the sigmoid activation function. Here the previous stage output is passing to the sigmoid passing to the sigma 10H activation functions. We can see in this figure also. Now we are going to discuss selective read operation. So after applying the selective write operation, we are getting the temporary state ST hyphen, which is represented by the ST hyphen. So this is your temporary state. Now in the selective write operations, we are selecting the useful information from the previous state. Now instead of passing the entire information, this information, we are reading the selective information from this from the temporary state. So we are using the input gate. Okay. So we are reading the only useful information from this temporary state with the help of input gate. IT represents the input gate, and the value of IT is calculated by this equation. Okay. And then this temporary state is multiplied by the input gate in order to get the ST. So this is your ST, and it is a point by multiplication of temporary state and input gate. So till now, what we did that this is your previous state ST minus 1, then we apply the output gate and we get ST minus 1. Then we get the temporary state ST hyphen. Then we then apply the input gate, and then finally we multiply the IT and temporary state to get the ST selective read operation. So we have discussed selective read write operation. Now, so what the input did? Now this is your input. So first we pass the previous hidden state. Current input to the sigmoid function, okay, and then you multiply the 10H output and the sigmoid output. Then we multiply this outputs. So you can see in this figure also. First we will multiply hidden state in the sigmoid activation function as well as in the 10H activation function, and then we will multiply both the equations. So this is for your selective read operations. So now we are going to discuss selective forget operations. So till now, what we did, we have applied the output gate or the selective write operation with the help of output gate. Then we apply the selective read operation with the help of input gate. Now we have S temporary state ST and ST minus 1 to get the new state ST. Forget get is used to decide the information, whether we should cap the information or throw the information. So what information is important from the previous state is received is capped here, and the rest of the unuseful information is thrown from this throw by this forget get. Okay. So this is your forget gate. Information from the previous hidden state and the information from the current input is passing through the sigmoid function. So what we are doing in the forget, just we are passing the information current input and the previous input and passing to the sigmoid in order to get the value between 0 to 1. If the value is 0, that means this information is forget. If the value is closer to 1, means to keep the informations. Now the next stage is cell state. So the cell state is basically, you have seen this in this equations, this information is stored into the cell state. So cell state, what cell state doing? That first cell state get the point wise multiplication by the forget vector. Now point by multiplication by the forget vector. Then we take the output from the input gate, then we get the output from the input gate and do the point-wise additions which update the cell state to the new state. So now the previous state, this is your temporary state which is multiplied by the input gate. This is your previous state which is multiplied by the for gate, and the addition of this information is stored into the cell state, which is known as the S, which is represented by the cell state ST. So we can see in this figure also, your S and your ST and IT is passing to the sigmoid activation functions, and then ST minus 1 and FT, and then perform the point wide additions. So this is your complete equations for the LSTM. Now first we will apply the selective write operation with the help of output gate. Then we apply the selective read operations with the help of input gate. Then forget is applies to select the useful informations from this, okay, and then perform the selective write operations to get the new hidden state. Now just because of this, as we have seen that in the previous example, in the case of RNN, your information is morphed again and again and again. That means your information is transformed by the each and every layer. So at the end, your input is completely morphed by the different layers. So here what the forget network did, this information is directly passing to the forget layers. So now these are the different gate that we have used: output gate, input gate, and forget gate. And these are the state. This is your temporary state. This is your final state, and this is your hidden states. This is for the wrong LSTM for the sequence labeling. So the same is here. Now these are your output gate. This is your ST gate. These are the references. Thank you.